dial zero.
Song when I don't. I mean, you know, I write hundreds of songs to get one good one. They don't all turn out, you know, presentable. Most of them aren't presentable. So, you know, when you write as many songs as I do, you know, you're bound to get. Even a blind pig finds an acorn sometimes, right?
He began his career as Johnny Cougar, a catchy hype type name laid on him by a manager. Since that start in the mid-70s, he has sold more than 30 million albums. And now the world knows him by his real name, John Mellencamp. Today, John has no image problem. He says exactly what he thinks and makes music exactly the way he wants. To get a taste of his newest album, E.T. went to where John makes music, down home.
As you brush your shoes, you stand before your mirror.
To fully appreciate John Mellencamp's staying power, consider this. The first time he performed Wild Night, his current top 10 single with Michelle and DeGiocello, was nearly 20 years ago, when it was a Van Morrison hit and John was doing his version in small clubs.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing, you know, back in the 60s, you know, it was a couple of records and out. And I just always kind of assumed that was the way it was going to be. But here, just 20 years later, we're still doing it. And Federal Express is still delivering here, so I guess stuff's still going on, you know.
But for John, it wouldn't be nearly as much if he weren't able to do it his way, which means here at his rural Indiana compound he affectionately calls the Belmont Mall.
When I bought this place, it was just a little shacky place that the raccoons really had taken over, and nobody had lived here for quite some time. So we just kind of added on and fixed it up and made it the place where we work. And here's the only security that we need here. I think that sends a strong enough message. Mm-hmm. It's the way we make the records now. It has 8 miles of drywall in it.
The Belmont Mall has long been the place where John and his band have crafted a string of hits that stretch back years. Beginning in the early 80s and continuing right on through to his new album, Dance Naked, this 40-something rocker, who's been described as having the soul of a teenager, says he'd just as soon do without the 90s.
And I'd probably be a lot more fun if it wasn't the 90s, I'll tell you. Too many damn laws in the 90s, too many new rules I don't like. You can't have fun in the 90s. 90s is not about having fun. It's about being politically correct. If it gets any worse, I'm going to bomb it. Let's have a good time. It's life. We only got so many years. Let's make the most of it. What are we sitting around on our thumbs for, acting like we that this is some kind of important business? It's just life. Laugh at it. Let's go. Let's try to have a good time.
The album, Dance Naked, is in stores right now. The next stop on John's tour is Wednesday in Boston, Massachusetts. John, by the way, is also an accomplished painter. He told us he has signed up with the New York Gallery for a show next spring.
With the